What is Lamarckism? Change in the environment causes changes in the needs of organisms living in that environment, which in turn causes the changes in their behavior. First law or proposition law. In evolution, during course of time, organisms or their component parts gradually tend to increase in size. Lamarck cited the evolution of horses as an example to explain this law. The modern horses, namely equus, evolved from very small ancestral forms called Hyracotherium or Eohippus. They gradually evolved into larger modern equus. Lamarck's opinion was based on fossils of several intermediate ancestors of horses. This finding is against the view already expressed by Lamarck. Thus, the first law of Lamarck was lost. Let us see the second law or proposition. If an organism is in need of an organ, sooner or later it will arise. Lamarck elaborated his view citing the lengthening of the neck in giraffe over the years. It is known through fossil records that the ancestors of modern giraffe were small and they had short neck and forelimbs. They lived in the grasslands of Africa. These ancestral animals were feeding on grasses and the leaves of small trees nearby. Gradually, as the grasslands were transformed into deserts, the animals became dependent on tall trees for food. Due to competition for food, they had to stretch their neck for more leaves. They strained their neck for several generations with a very strong inner feeling to have a longer neck. This strong desire, in course of time, led to gradual increase in the length of neck and forelimbs. In this explanation, Lamarck considered that mere want or inner feeling to possess a particular character can lead to the origin of such a character. This view of Lamarck is not accepted by modern evolutionists. Third law or proposition, law of use and disuse. The constant use of an organ changes its efficiency and makes that organ to increase in size with better development. Similarly, if an organ is not used for a long time, it might lead to reduction in efficiency and size of that organ. The development of hand muscles of a blacksmith and thigh muscles in the legs of an experienced runner were quoted as examples. Fourth law or proposition, inheritance of acquired characters. Bodily changes or new characteristics obtained by an organism during its lifetime will automatically get transferred to the next generation. In 1890, the German scientist August Weimann performed some experiments with the rats. He selected a set of healthy male and female rats. He started cutting their tails continuously for more than 20 generations. This experiment was performed to verify inheritance of the acquired character, namely the tailless condition. Interestingly, such a condition was never observed in any of the young rats born. This finding led to the proposition of the theory that any changes to the body region, that is the somatoplasm, will not have influence over the reproductive cells, that is germplasm. Thus, Weimann for the first time segregated germplasm from the somatoplasm. This led to the formulation of germplasm theory, which states that any change to the somatoplasm will not have an influence over the germplasm.